In this video, you will learn what steps to take if the latches for a Von Duprin or Falcon EL device are not electrically retracting properly. These are the tools you may need. Please note, electric latch retraction devices should be serviced by a qualified technician. To spend your time most effectively, it is recommended to follow these steps in the order they are presented in this video. First, checking the power supply and wiring. Then, addressing mechanical operation and electrical components. And finally, checking the solenoid plunger adjustment. First, locate the power supply and visually confirm that the power supply being used is the PS914. Confirm the text PS914 is imprinted on the green main circuit board of the power supply. The PS914 is the only power supply that has been tested to provide the 16 amp inrush necessary to retract the latches. Please note, the discontinued PS873 power supply may also be used. Next, visually confirm that the power supply has either the 900-2RS or 900-4RL option board. The text 900-2RS or 900-4RL is imprinted on the circuit board. The option board functions as a relay to isolate the access control contact, which may not be rated for 16 amps. The board also prevents the power supply from overload in situations with multiple devices by firing each one sequentially. If the power supply is incorrect, or if the option boards are missing, contact your supplier for assistance. Next, check that the wire gauge is appropriate for the distance between the power supply and the power transfer. These are the wires connected to the output terminals and ground. 14-gauge wire may be used up to 100 feet, and 12-gauge wire may be used up to 200 feet. Please note, 18-gauge wire or excessive wire lengths are not adequate for the 16-amp inrush. If 18-gauge wire is used, inconsistent operation will occur. Please note, if the power transfer uses a lighter gauge wire, this is acceptable and would not be a reason for a latch retraction issue. After checking the power supply and wire gauge, verify that the power supply is functioning. When connected to power, the AC light on the PS914 should be green, and the DC light should be red. The voltage jumper must be securely set for 24 volts, as shown. If the jumper needs to be repositioned, first remove AC power from the unit, then move the jumper. Using a voltmeter or multimeter, confirm that the two DC output terminals on the PS914 motherboard measure 24 volts. Next, test the voltage from the option board. Ensure the fire alarm jumper is securely installed or that a fire alarm board is installed with a normally closed fire alarm contact. If the jumper or board is not present, there will be no DC output from the option board. Please note, you may need a second person to activate the input signal. With the option board wired according to the installation instructions, provide a dry input signal, such as a card swipe, to the option board, and use the multimeter to confirm that the output and ground terminals measure 24 volts for the period of time programmed by the access control product or power supply. If the output does not measure 24 volts, temporarily jumper the input terminals on the option board and measure the voltage. If 24 volts are present when using the jumper wire, check your input product or input wiring for a malfunction. If the red DC light goes out and the fuse attempts to reset when the EL device is activated, there is an electrical overload condition that must be addressed. For example, multiple devices may be attempting to fire at the same time due to improper configuration of the option board, or there may be a short in the wiring, improper wire gauge, or a damaged pulse width module in the exit device. If the power supply lights do not come on when powered, or 24 volts is not measured at the DC output or option board, contact your supplier or customer care. After confirming the wire gauge and power supply operation, mechanically inspect the exit device. First, ensure the device is not mechanically dogged. Next, check that all latches retract and extend fully when mechanically operated. Ensure the device is not restricted from operating. If rim latching or vertical rods or cables are used, ensure the latches fully retract and extend as shown. To help determine if the cause is electrical or mechanical, disconnect the device from vertical rods or cables or from the mortise lock. For example, if the EL device starts to work when disconnected, the rods, cables, or mortise finger may need adjustment. If the latches do not retract and extend properly, visit www.allegion.com/US for documents and videos on latch adjustment, or call customer care. After the power supply, wire gauge, voltage, and mechanical operation have been checked and tested, inspect the EL components of the device. If multiple devices are being powered, disconnect all but one device from the power source and check each device individually. Check the voltage at the pulse width module. Power the device and check the voltage from the pulse width module using care not to touch the test leads on the multimeter. While the device is powered, approximate readings should be 22.6 DC volts on the green to yellow contacts and 24 DC volts on the green to orange contacts. If the proper voltage is not coming from the pulse width module, this could be the result of faulty wire connections or, in rare cases, a damaged pulse width module. Ensure all wire-to-wire connections are secure. The final item to check is the solenoid itself, although it is rarely the cause of latch retraction issues. To test the two coils, first set your meter to ohms. Measure the green to yellow contact, which should measure between 1.2 and 2.2 ohms. Then, measure the green to orange contact and confirm the measurement is correct for your device type. Use this table to determine the correct measurement. If each troubleshooting step has been performed, but the device latch still does not remain retracted when powered, adjust the plunger. This step applies only to von Duprin EL devices. Loosen the black 3/32 inch cap screw on the plunger. Then, turn the 3/8 inch hex head of the brass threaded bushing. You will need to hold the plunger in place while you rotate the hex head. Back out the bushing until the plunger holds when power is applied. Tighten the cap screw on a flat portion of the threaded bushing. Install the mechanism case cover plate before final testing, as pressure from the plate could impact operation. The plunger should seat in the solenoid, and the latches should remain fully retracted. For more information or assistance, visit us.allegion.com/EL-support or contact customer care at 877-671-7011.